Good morning. Today is Monday, October 2nd. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Blessed Brother James Miller, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Shamrocks. I'm Zach Hartwig.
My name is Patrick Dinahan.
And this is your morning news.
Chipotle fundraiser. Do you like Chipotle? We're selling you for sponsoring a fundraiser on Tuesday, October 3rd, between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m. at the Norwich location, 4235 North Harmon Avenue. When you make a purchase on this day, 33% of the sales get donated to a good cause. Student IDs. Students are forbidden from removing or taking other students' IDs. IDs are the personal property of each student, and the dean's office will enforce consequences for any student who removes someone's student ID.
Starting today, all students must be wearing their IDs around their necks. A 1 hour after school detention will be issued for all students without an ID. If you need a replacement ID, see Mr. Biancalan during lunch immediately. Replacement cost is $5.
Hello everyone, our next all-school Mass is coming up, and so just wanted to do a refresher on how to receive Holy Communion. First, it's important to remember that as Catholics, we believe that the bread and wine that are consecrated at Holy Mass become the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus. We believe that the fullness of Jesus, his whole personhood, exists after the priest says, "This is my body, this is my blood." And so because we truly believe it is Jesus, not a symbol of Jesus or a metaphor of Jesus, or that it's Jesus for just a short amount of time, we take great care in how we distribute our Lord in the Eucharist at Holy Communion. And also, we want to make sure that we are in the proper disposition of heart to receive our Lord, Catholic or not. And so let's begin with who can and should not receive Holy Communion. First, Holy Communion, because of what we believe the Eucharist is, the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus, only Catholics who are baptized and received into the church, some may have been converted into the church, only those who believe in the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist can receive Holy Communion. So while many of you might be Christian and other denominations of Christianity, we all believe Holy Communion to be a little different, and part of communion, the word, means that those receiving it are in communion in their belief. And so only those who are Catholic should receive Holy Communion. For those of us who are Catholic, only those that are in a state of grace should receive Holy Communion. So anyone who has not been to confession within a year, those who have not been to Sunday Mass without confessing that in a while, or have any other mortal sins on their soul, you should not receive Holy Communion, because we want our hearts to be in a disposition to receive the fullness of God's grace. Those sins that weigh us down, especially mortal sin, prevent us from receiving the fullness of grace and prevent us from being a pure vessel to receive this great gift the Lord wants to give us. So anyone who is not Catholic and who is not in a state of grace should not be receiving Holy Communion. Now, for those of you who are going to receive Holy Communion, there are different ways you can receive, but also different ways you should not receive, and that's what we're going to cover now. Now, If you are not receiving Holy Communion, you are welcome to stay in your pew. You do not have to come up. But if you would like to come up in procession, you're more than welcome to. We ask that you put your arms across your chest like I'm doing now so that you can either receive a blessing from the minister or a blessing from the priest. If you are going to be receiving communion, what you should never do is take the Eucharist out of the minister's hand. What you're receiving is a gift, and gifts are not meant to be taken. They are meant to be received. The proper response when receiving Holy Communion is amen after the minister says the body of Christ. You say amen after we say the body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
And you receive our Lord as the great gift that he is. You do not say thank you or just stare at us awkwardly.
The body of Christ.
Thank you.
When you do receive Holy Communion, the best ways to receive the Eucharist are either on your tongue while standing or in your hand, and also kneeling on your tongue.
The body of Christ.
Those three ways are what are preferred by the church. And so if you receive in your hand, we want you to actually make a throne out of your hand. So your dominant hand that you write with should be on the bottom, your other hand on top. The goal is to not drop Jesus. Remember, it's the fullness of God in that little piece of what looks like bread and tastes like bread is the fullness of divinity. We do not want Jesus to end up on the floor or in your pocket or somewhere else in church. You are to receive him on your hand, and immediately after you receive our Lord, you put Jesus directly in your mouth as you consume our Lord's full body, blood, soul, and divinity. If you're receiving on the tongue, if you're standing, we want you to put your head back and stick out your tongue far enough for the minister to place our Lord on your tongue. If you're kneeling, the same, put your head back a bit and stick your tongue out all the way so that the minister can safely place our Lord on your tongue for you to consume him. I hope this has been helpful to you. Thank you for your attention, and I hope this helps all of us worship God together as a Shamrock family. God bless you all. We'll see you at Mass.
We're just going to be asking people what they love about St. Pat's, and yeah, we'll see how that goes. All right, so I'm here with
Ms. Gaona.
And this is her favorite thing about St. Pat's.
Definitely the spirit. Our Shamrocks are ready to give it all. Thank you so much for a great spirit.
All right, so I'm here with
Daniel Wheeler.
And this is what he loves about St. Pat's.
I absolutely love the clubs. I made some of the best friends I've ever had at these clubs.
I'm here with
Ms. Robinson.
And this is her favorite thing about St. Pat's.
My students.
I like it. All right, so I'm here with
Nathan Davila.
This is what he loves about St. Pat's.
What I love about St. Pat's is all the guys I see all in the halls. They make my day really good, and I just love St. Pat's.
So I'm here with
Sean Kroger.
This is what he loves about St. Pat's.
I just like how all the students and teachers are always there to help you and just will always be there for you.
All right, so I'm here with
Emilio.
This is what he loves about St. Pat's.
My favorite part about St. Pat's is how chill the teachers are, and like, sometimes it's like they're not even your teacher, they're like your friends. So it's like they're chill with you, they're nice to you, and they're just down with everything.
All right, thank you. So I'm here with
Matthew.
This is what he loves about St. Pat's.
Just love football.
Pizza time.
The games are pretty chaotic, very hilarious what they do. Just love the atmosphere in general.
All right, I'm here with
A Money,
Nolan,
Josh.
This is what they love about St. Pat's. What do you love about St. Pat's?
Oh, the brotherhood, everybody close, and
we just be, you know, it's fun. Every day is activity or something.
I like the closeness. Everybody is so like close. Everybody knows everybody, and like you can like count on most people.
The community is very good, brotherhood, you know what I mean? So, I love the community. We have a great faculty as well. Great faculty.
No way.
Ryan Burt.
Joey Figo.
Eli.
Nolan.
All right, and this is what they love about St. Pat's.
I love being around all my friends and all the teachers.
I love the way the brotherhood is, and I love how we have fun together. Let's go Shamrocks. Rawr.
I love the Shamrock pride and brotherhood, and of course I love lunches here at St. Patrick.
I love hanging out with my friends at school all day, and like Ryan said, the lunch is pretty good.
All right, that concludes our segment for today about what do you love about St. Pat's.